Good evening, everyone. Welcome to the Northeast Culture Gallery Factory in Northeast Minneapolis. We're here tonight with John Salhus to talk a little bit more about his Reaching the Islands exhibition, which opened up on June 5th and is up through July 12th. So, a few more days before it closes. My name is Christopher Atkins. I'm a writer, curator, and artist. I've been here in the Twin Cities. Been here for a long time. I want to start by saying thanks to the Northeast Sculpture Gallery and Factory, specifically John Hawk, for the invitation to be here tonight. I've been really looking forward to talking with you all, and also to John for having this conversation. First things first, we're going to go around the show. Bear with us. We're doing our best to socially distance, but also wear our masks. So we're going to try to speak a little bit louder than we normally would, just so that we can have you hear us as good as possible. I want to introduce John Salhus.
Hey, how you doing? Thanks for being with us this evening.
We had a couple of thoughts about how the talk will go tonight. There's a couple of themes. We had a couple of themes that we had in mind for the show that John and I were talking about over the past few minutes. And we thought it would be a good place to begin. And I know we've got a lot to talk about already, so we might as well just jump in and get started.
Let's do it.
Does that sound good?
Yeah.
Cool. So I was here for the opening back in June, and I really enjoyed seeing all of the work. It was great to see it. I've only seen a few things of your work on Instagram, and we have a lot of mutual friends as well, too.
Yeah.
And nothing that had show up in the art center. So 2 years ago?
2016.
Oh, so 4 years ago.
I think.
And these are all relatively new paintings, right?
These were all done from January of 2019 till COVID happened.
To COVID.
Yeah.
And this was made in your studio after quarantine.
During quarantine, yeah. Yeah. Wow. Yeah. So, yeah. 4 weeks before the show, I built this.
Good.
Yeah.
Yeah. And it's all cardboard, stained cardboard, right?
Yeah.
The thing I wanted to start by talking about are some of the things that I noticed kind of throughout all the paintings that I'm doing here. So they're all paintings, of course, but in each of them there seems to be an interest in paintings within paintings, right? If you look at right behind the belt, right here is one. Can we turn around real quick?
What's this one called again?
Painter's Head.
Painter's Head,
yeah.
It was a sort of portrait. But then all of these vertical, what look like bookends, are actually paintings, right?
Paintings, yes. Yeah. Stacked paintings.
And they're all older paintings, or something new?
Well, there's some new ones, some old ones. Some of the paintings are actually specific.
Right.
Some of the ones with the writing on the edge are actual paintings. Some of them are from way back.
And is it sitting on is it an island itself?
No, it's just on the ground. It's just a reflection. It's after you do this for so many years, you have stacks and piles of
right.
work. And it's, you know, what you think of 24/7.
Right.
And it's always running through your mind. It's the process, the creative process. So it's really about the creative process and what comes from doing that for a long time.
The accumulation of it.
Yes.
The things that you have stored up in your home studio.
Stop it.
Right.
Stop. They're in the kitchen.
Yeah.
They're everywhere.
Are they on the bed too?
Not yet. Yeah. That's the next storage spot.
What's the name called?
The Nightline.
The Nightline. And I was thinking about this a little bit. I had taken a couple pictures when we were here in June. And the reason I wanted to talk about this one a little bit is partially because the palette is the repeated thing here. It's in the bottom right corner here. It's also in sort of the middle bottom of that one over there. But like the others, there's also this interest in paintings within paintings, right? Now, I don't think these are your paintings, or perhaps they are. Now, are they signed the same way as this one, and are these specific ones? Do you have titles for them?
No, they're paintings within this painting that are just by themselves, but everything is based on something that I've been working on, or a sketchbook, or some of these, yeah, some of these are very specific paintings, and some of them are more like an idea of a painting, and it varies.
And a lot of that sketching you're talking about happens on some of these excursions you're taking, right? Some of these canoe trips and adventures that you have?
Well, I'm always carrying around a sketchbook because I travel a lot for my day job. Recent ideas that become just bodies of water with things floating in them. Americana. This is another island with some debris and stuff. So this is where they all start.
Have you ever considered showing your sketchbook?
He must have a bunch. Sketching wasn't always part of this process.
Okay.
The last, 8 years, they've become part of the process. And I don't get to film up as often as I wish.
Right.
So, because I'm working on this stuff.
Right.
So it's when I'm traveling, or in the car, to stop real quick, or, middle of the night, write down that idea. So, yeah.
The other thing that what I really liked about the title of the show, Reaching the Islands, is that it was probably thought of way before we're in this time of social distancing, quarantine. But I can't help but think about islands and isolation nowadays.
Yeah.
It seems it's no accident that so many of your paintings are about islands and places that people are sort of isolated from, perhaps, right?
Yeah.
And not necessarily all of these are places that you visit, but they're sort of, some of them have stories connected to them, of the places you're actually been, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yes. Well, what do you think about that idea of islands as it relates to your work as a constant theme that kind of shows up over and over?
Yeah, the islands are pretty recent. This work. Yeah, the show's called Reaching the Islands, and because it's the journey of life. We're all traveling through this space, and we come to different islands, and it's at those islands we make decisions and go left, go right, or they might be filled with something good or something bad. So that's really the same.
There's something quite, I can imagine that idea of an island being something quite good and bad as well.
Yeah.
There's a certain, the utopic vision of an island is a place that has everything. It's always on the horizon, something that you strive for,
yeah.
A place that has everything that you need.
Right.
But then you're stuck. Then you have to send a message in a bottle, perhaps, off the island to get rescued, right? So.
Yeah. So. Yeah, usually, talking about specifics, in the painting usually where I like to go.
Sure.
It's pretty literal.
Sure.
it's right there.
You're right.
Yeah.
Tell me a little bit about text in your painting. I'm trying to sort of think about those things that I feel like are showing up in all of these pieces. But there's usually the one right behind you.
Yeah.
see how we are.
Yeah, you know, the text started coming out, and I think it's because it's almost like, you know, I work spontaneously, painting, drawing. I draw straight from my head. I don't use photographs. Specific moments I'll use a photograph for a reference, but everything is straight up in my head. And so the boards and the debris and the destruction and the piles comes from, you know, and there's water and everything.
Everywhere.
So there's a constant flow of water, and I see the water as creativity or life, you know, of course.
True.
You know, water is life.
Water everywhere.
But it's
right.
Also all the, you know, the stuff that can be in that river.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, garbage and a town.
Yeah.
Yeah. In some cases, it's a whole town.
Right.
Or a studio.
Right.
Someone's studio. In some of these, it's my studio in the river.
Sure.
And so, and then once you're traveling, you have markers, signposts, signs telling you which way to go. Decisions to be made, a fork in the river,
sure.
You know, that. So.
I think what you've done here is given the water some personality as well, too. I always feel like the water can be so calm and so beautiful, but then it can also be so tumultuous.
Yeah.
It could be a person, you know, in a way.
Right.
Maybe you look at rapids or calmness.
Oh, definitely.
So I always felt like looking at this, there's different personalities in each of these paintings as well, too.
It's definitely a being.
Yeah.
Yeah. So.
Tell me a little bit about, this one here we talked a little bit about is this photograph of, well, it's a photograph of, it's a painting of a photograph, is that right? Of the Louvre?
The Louvre.
The Louvre, yeah. And there's also the painting of the rock up here, sort of basically painting of a static and sharp kind of painting. But this is a great sort of example of, you know, old and new, surrealist and pop, going to be. You know,
sometimes
I threw it all in there.
Like along for the ride.
Yeah. But I feel like unless my hands would turn into just not something close to what was this. And I like what you said before, you talked a little bit about that. You know, you're working without sort of photographs to help you with composition, right?
Right.
You said that a lot of your early parts of the painting are really action related. There's a lot of movement.
Well, it's just that I'm not physically moving with it. So I start with nothing,
right.
And I work, and then, you know, I usually have a drawing out of a sketchbook that I want to go towards,
right.
But I don't use it, I don't project it,
right.
I'm not trying to make it an exact copy of the drawing, but I use that for a starting point. Yeah, but then it develops into what it develops into. Things come into it, you know, like the clown pattern.
Yeah.
You know,
you really love color, don't you?
I think about it a lot.
Yeah. So what is it? You're using blues and oranges. Are you using, you know, the kind of the Harlequin kind of patterns on the clown? And it's really done.
It's all good.
When you say you think about it a lot, what is it that you think about? Just how
no, I mean, when I think about color, it's just what, you know, what most visual artists think about. But I love color relationships.
Right.
So yeah, I mean, you know, when composing the painting, when composing the painting, I want to think about color.
Good.
Yeah.
Shows up again.
Yeah.
So, are you doing more sculpture? Is this sort of just something that you've been thinking about doing?
Well, on some of the
gallery installations that I've done in the last few years. I have two-dimensional work, and then in the center of the gallery, I have three-dimensional work, almost like the viewers, we are in the water.
Yeah.
You know, we're standing in the water, there's the island, every painting has water in it pretty much. So in the gallery, we are in the water, and the sculpture almost. I started working with the cardboard because sometimes when I'm working straight out of my head, those paintings, I need to visualize something, and I can't just make it up.
Right.
So I needed a log in water,
so
I made a lot of cardboard, dropped it on the ground, and then I could, you know, get down and see, because I wanted to be at this level of the water.
Right.
So what does a log look like, you know, in a different way, but what did it look like? So I built a log, because I live in Chicago, and I didn't have a log in a river, right, you know, available.
So
I made one. And then I started making more, and pretty soon I had a whole bunch of logs in my studio just piled up.
Right.
And I've done a couple installations with waterfalls and logs. And they're white because I like to negate, because I use found cardboard, so, you know, liquor boxes, whatever. And so they've got so many different printing and things on there, so I like to negate that by just doing it white. Then it feels more like a drawing to me.
This must feel like hundreds of Amazon boxes.
Yeah, but I don't order from Amazon.
No, that's okay.
You said that you had an idea of how this might be a public sculpture subject, perhaps. Yeah.
No,
that's on the down wall.
Oh, okay.
I was chatting.
That was. If it is, I think it's a cool idea. So.
Alright, I don't know anything about what you just said.
Just forget I said that.
Yeah.
So, is that cool?
I like doing some installation.
Got it.
Yeah.
So, you work at your home studio in Chicago.
I do.
You're lucky enough to have your home and your studio in one place, right? I've heard a lot of stories about people who just can't get in their studios nowadays.
So yeah.
Kind of either working from home and just with the materials they have.
Yeah.
Or they're just figuring it out, or they're...
It's pretty, you know, as a visual artist, it's pretty nice to be able to just, you know, have your studio at home. I love working away from home also, but
sure.
In these times, it's pretty nice to be able to walk out into the studio.
Really?
So, yeah, it's been okay.
Yeah. And my wife recently moved home too, and she's really enjoyed being able to get up and work. What's next for it? Are you working on that? You're not doing your day
job. Some more islands.
Yeah.
Yeah. Just a continuation of this work, and we'll see where the river takes it.
Good.
Yeah.
Last question I wanted to ask you too is that a lot of the islands that you begin with, a lot of the inspiration for these painting and your work comes from your travels, right?
Right.
Are there any trips that have been particularly important or that are coming up that might inform these new islands, or is it just kind of where the sketchbook is with you at any time?
Yeah, I mean, it could be, you know, because we work in really remote places and big cities like San Diego.
Right.
I just spent 2 months there, so it's, or I could be in St. Thomas, Virgin Islands right there.
Yeah.
You know, that was, I got back from St. Thomas and that painting came out. So,
is it good?
Yeah.
Is it all?
Ride That Wave. Yeah, these are actually specific paintings.
Drawings,
yeah. So this is like my studio in a wave.
Right.
Yeah.
And that's the thing I really like about these works is that you do your own kind of cutting and pasting with your own images. The way they kind of show up in different places, whether it's a piece of one or entire ones or just your whole studio being destroyed by a wave.
Yeah. And you know, it's a fragile thing.
Yeah.
You know, based on recent events, and we think it's so secure.
Right.
This life, but it's really not.
I've been really surprised by just some very small changes.
There's some destruction. For some reason, I think of places like Syria, and artists living in Syria, what that would be like. Or, artists from World War II that were hunted.
Right.
That's extreme, right?
I really enjoyed spending some time with this work and hearing more about it. Like I said, the exhibition's up through July 12th, and I guess you can follow North East Sculpture Gallery Factory for more information. Is there anything else you want to say before we...
No.
Yeah. That's great.
Yeah. Thank you.
Thanks, everybody.